Guys, and welcome back to another episode of the 500 Trophy Brawler series. Guys, in today's video, I'll be getting Poke up to 500 trophies, plus give you guys the best tips and tricks, plus the best maps on how to push your trophies with Poco, and how to get him up to 500 trophies very easily. Also, guys, did a lot of episodes on this. We done Primo, Barley, Pam, Frank, and we did Carl. So make sure to check out that playlist on the other brawlers. Also, guys, one small note, if you're seeing my Carl very low, I pushed him on my main account up to 500 trophies, and that was yesterday's video, so make sure to check that video out. So yeah, that's all the brawlers we got. Now on this video, as I said, I'm gonna get him up to 500 trophies, give you guys the best tips and tricks, best map, plus how to play Poco, plus his mechanics, plus an advanced guide on him. Now to this 500 trophy match, currently I'm spawned here. This was the same spawn I got in my 500 Carl video. So yeah, here I always love to take the bottom lower place of this map. So here I was incredibly lucky that that guy didn't come up to me. Also, he didn't have that much health, so he ran away, and he wants to spin and team with me, which I don't team with anyone. So yeah, here I'm just trying to get him out of this spawn and get him out here so I could start bush camping until I get the 6 trophies left for me to get him to up to 500 trophies. Yeah, I was just pushing him back up. Now here I'm sitting down in this map. Also, guys, Feast or Famine energy drink is the best map to push your trophies in. So if you're struggling to get a brawler up to 500 trophies, make sure to push him, push your brawler in this video and this map. I mean, I'll make a video for you guys on this map and how to push very easily, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Now here I'm just camping out. We got 7 brawlers left, and if we lose right now, we're gonna get lose 2 trophies. Here's where the bull comes back up to us. Here he's just spinning again. I don't want to get involved into any teaming with that bull. So yeah, well, we got 1,669 damage, 6 brawlers left right now. Okay, and that bull is very low. So here we got that bull low, very low, and destroyed that bull right now. We got that Shelly came on us. I don't know, we got super lucky she didn't come and kill us. Here I was super nervous that the Poco, the Shelly was still above us. So yeah, here I was just shipping at this, not shipping, I was just shooting up above myself to see if there's someone above me, and to just check up if that Shelly was close to me. Now we got 3 brawlers left. I go to the other side in hopes of them not seeing me. So I went to the lower area of this, just ran away, barely got lucky, and we got that second place, which means we're gonna get the 500 trophy Poco as we guys want. So guys, now we're gonna get into Poco stats and mechanics. This was just a 500 match. As you see, we got him up to 500 trophies. This is our 6th or 7th brawler up to 500 trophies. Make sure to comment down below which brawler you want me to push up to 500 next, plus make sure to subscribe to my channel and like this video for more amazing content. Now let's get into his stats. Just a small disclaimer, all stats in this video is compared to a level 10 Poco. So if you got a lower Poco, make sure it's gonna be the same, but here we got higher damage and HP and super healing, and you don't have the star power. But if you have a level 10, you just need to follow this video and you're gonna be okay. Now the health is 5,320. His damage is 924. His super, he heals up to 2,960 HP. And his star power is Poco. Poco's attack heals friendly brawlers for 500 HP every time he shoots at them, and the friendly brawler is in contact of Poco. So yeah. Now we're gonna get into some small info about Poco to get warmed up before we get into the bigger stuff for you guys. Number one is he's a rare brawler. So Poco, guys, is a very easy brawler to get. He's not that incredibly difficult to get because he's a rare brawler. He's on the in the scale of getting on how difficulty of getting him is he's to Primo, Rosa, and Barley. So he's not that hard to get as a rare brawler. So if you have some brawlers, if you don't have Pokemon, you're gonna get him very soon because he's a rare brawler, and like rare brawlers don't take that much to just get unlocked. Number two is he is used as a gym carrier in gym grab. And yeah, if you're playing in gym grab, I'm gonna give you guys the other game modes. For us, gym grab is he's going mid. He's going to get all the gems from the middle, and yeah, let you guys win because you have the support brawlers and the aggro brawlers, and Poco is a gym carrier who goes mid all the time. Number three is he's the worst brawler in Brawl Stars. Let's not say he's the worst. Let's say he's one of the worst brawlers because Shelly is as well as like the same she's the same like. As worse as Poco, so yeah, Poco as well is the worst brawler in Brawl Stars. Now, also in Siege, you play Poco as a healer, which means a support brawler. Plus, you could use him as the bolt carrier, which is a very very which is a thing in Siege. Also in Brawl Ball, he's also a support brawler. He supports heals the tanks, and yeah, he's a very excellent brawler in the game modes. Now after we got this info about him and everyone should know about them, these things. Now let's get into the tier list of where Poco lands in every single game mode, plus overall in Brawl Stars. So yeah, let's start in Gem Grab. He's an A tier brawler. He's not the best brawler in into Gem Grab, but he's an A tier brawler. And yeah, in Gem Grab, as I said, he plays as the gem carrier, and he got the gem carrier role. And yeah, he always goes for the gems, picks them up, and heals the teammates. He lands mainly as a gem carrier plus a support baller, in my opinion. But a lot of people categorize him as a gem carrier. But for me, he could be a gem carrier plus a support baller. So that's what makes Poco the support and gem carrier brawler. Now, as you guys always said, he's an A tier brawler. In solo showdown, he's a D tier brawler. As well as duo showdown, he's a D tier brawler. As you guys see, Poco isn't that perfect in Brawl Stars. He's a D tier brawler in showdown, but I got him up to 500 trophies in in showdown, which was feast or famine, which is very easy to for you to push any brawler up to 500 trophies. So yeah, I'll do a video for you guys on how to push in that map with any brawler, so make sure to stay tuned for that. So yeah, showdown, how could he be worse, guys? Because he gets countered by a lot of the tanks, because there's a lot of bush camping higher in trophies. But the thing that made Poco not an F tier brawler was a lot of people team with him, so Poco isn't that bad. And yeah, he could be good as teaming, because that teaming makes him the D tier brawler. So if no one teams with him, he's like a close to F tier brawler in showdown. Now let's get into heist. Heist, guys, as you know, he's an F tier brawler. He doesn't work as well in heist because in heist you need to take down the safe. And Poco doesn't take the safe as fast as he could, because in heist you need to bring a lot of high DPS brawlers, but Poco has a small DPS, has 900, which is very low. So yeah, I wouldn't recommend you playing slash pushing your Poco in heist, because you're gonna fail and lose a lot of your trophies. So yeah, now in Brawl Ball, he's an A tier brawler, guys. As I just talked about it, Brawl Ball, Gem Grab and Brawl Ball are the two best game modes to push your Poco on, because Brawl Ball, Poco got a very long large range, and it's very long, and it could take out a lot of the brawlers, plus take the ball and score with it. So yeah, I would recommend you pushing your Poco and Brawl Ball and with the selected comp, and you could get very easy trophies with them. Now in Bonnie, he's an F tier brawler, as well as in Siege, he's a C tier brawler. Guys, these two maps, game modes, I don't want you to push your Pocos in them, In Siege, you could do it with the best team comp, which is Poco, Frank, and like Barley and the other maps. I wouldn't recommend you pushing them. Yeah, and so yeah, that's gonna give it get you guys to lose a lot of your trophies. So yeah, now overall in Brawl Stars, he's a D tier brawler because he's very like very bad in like Barney. He's very hard and harder. He's an F tier brawler in Showdown. He's like a D tier, and Siege is a C tier. So that's what makes Poco the worst brawler, one of the worst brawlers in Brawl Stars. So yeah, that he is very hard to push, as you guys know. Here's some tips. So guys, play Poco and Gym Grab plus Gym as a Gym Carrier, or to push your Poco very easily. Number two is don't go for the tanks. Don't just pinch the tanks if you're in Gym Grab and you need to take out the Gym Carrier. Like if it's a Gym Carrier was Poco, let the aggro or the support brawler take him out. So yeah, don't use Poco to destroy all the other people. And lastly is one more thing is to always keep your range away from the other people. So yeah, you don't get killed by them. So now now the best maps for Poco is all the Gym Grab maps, some Brawl Ball maps, and some Siege maps with the preferred comp. So guys, the downside of Poco currently is Pam plus Rosa, and the tanks and the longer range roller, they out counter him and out range him very easily. So I wouldn't recommend you pushing your like this brawler in other game modes, and again the game modes I said in the tier list, plus these the brawlers that could outrange him or do better than him. So guys, that's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe to my channel, like this video for more amazing content, and comment down below which brawler I should push next up to 500 trophies. We have done a lot of brawlers, but we still have a lot more to continue. So guys, that's it for this episode. Make sure to smash the subscribe button. See you guys in Monday's video. Peace.